The first Batman movie, you know, Jack Nicholson in it, you know, he's got such interesting toys, you know, that whole thing. So I've got this girlfriend, right? And I'm going to this premiere. I hate premieres because they're crowded. And so it's 89 and I'm waiting because she's taking forever. And guys, if you've got a girl that just takes like an hour getting ready for something and you're not, there's no ring on your finger, run. All right, seriously. Anyways, I'm waiting. Well, she finally comes down the stairs and she's wearing something. And I'm like, I was shocked at how little she had on. And I went, you're wearing that? Oh, man. She spun right around, went back upstairs. We were about late for the movie. Anyway, that's my Batman story. and she almost got me in a fight in the theater because there was two idiots that were sitting in front of me. And Kim Basinger had been in a movie 9.5 weeks with, I think it was Mickey Rourke, and it was like all super sexy. And so these two knuckleheads were in lust with her, and every time she was on screen, they were making these weird moaning noises, so really irritating. Well, she tells him to shut up and stop being disgusting, right? And these two guys turn around and look at her, and they look at me, I'm like, great. So fortunately, there was no violence or bloodshed, but so just don't date girls like that, I guess. That was the moral of the story. Back to the Wing Chun Punch. Hey guys, Sifu Jason back, Greenville Academy Martial Arts. Thank you for watching. We're talking about the Wing Chun straight punch today. And obviously it's like the battle fist of Wing Chun. It's a workhorse of Wing Chun. And I want to go over some structure with it because it's so versatile in its use. It can be used as a long range punch. You know, I could be kind of thinking of using it a bit more of the extension. I could be using it when I'm holding and hitting somebody. All of those things can be of use for you if you get the structure down. So let's talk about the structure. Let's get away from the tactical application of it right now and just go to the structure to make sure you're not making a couple of big mistakes with it. Number one, the first time you see the punch is in the form. Now, I know some Wing Chun instructors will say that this isn't really a punch, that it's really defining the vertical center line. I've heard that from very good sources and some very reputable people, and I just disagree. If I'm defining the line, why am I making a fist? The first thing this is telling us that we should be hitting with the bottom three knuckles. Ring finger knuckles should be the focal point, and that keeps your wrist as straight as possible. Jack Dempsey, who knew a little bit about punching, Jack liked that three knuckle landing as well in the vertical fist. It's really not seen as much today because people are doing this. They have gloves on. For a bare knuckle punch, this punch, the vertical fist with a palm, with the palm to the side, thumb up, is the best structural punch for you. I mean, our shoulders are a ball and socket joint. And we walk around with our hands like this. So it comes right up, right? We don't have our hands like this. And when you punch, if you have your palm down, that's disconnecting your elbow from the power source. It's actually flaring out. I'm not saying you can't get power from that, but I am saying that structurally speaking, this is safer for you. It's also better to integrate into other issues in terms of keeping people, you know, if they're trying to get in and tackle you and so forth. This punch is better. So when your first thing you look at is the punch should be straight and the bottom three knuckles are in. Okay, that's number one. That's the first thing Wing Chun is telling you. The second thing it's telling you is don't load up the punch. The punch should be quick, right from the target. I shouldn't be thinking of drawing back. So it's gonna help you become very efficient because the punch is very direct, right? That's the big thing right there as well, because it's very natural for all of us to draw back to get power. And the other thing it does, if you'll watch what I'm doing here, is I'm not wheeling the shoulders around. I can get some more power by really extending, but that turns one shoulder back. We've seen this over the years in MMA, that MMA guys are boxing, but they're doing a particular type of boxing. They're very careful not to overextend because that leaves them vulnerable. Well, how much more vulnerable can you, when you think about a fight, You know, really, think about this. One thing for me to be, you know, sparring with a guy, and he pop, and I touch gloves, and that was a good shot. And somebody's trying to kill me. You know, he nails me because I get overextended, and then he beats me to death. That's a far greater problem, right? So it's not something you're going to just kind of be cavalier about. It's like you can go for paintball, and your buddy tells you, hey, run out there, I'll cover you. Okay. And paintball. In a real gunfight, we go, hey, run out there and cover you. No, you run out there, I'll cover you. So, you know, you want to be careful because it's your life. And so this issue of keeping things compact is really important, okay? Now, again, three-knuckle landing, don't telegraph, don't wheel around too far because you're in tight quarters and you don't want to get shoved into something, grabbed, thrown, and so forth. So that's the other big structural issue that the Wing Chun punch is giving you. Okay, it's telling you to keep your punches compact. Now, another mistake, as you know me, I go into application a bit and I can't help myself. We throw 3, 4, 5 punches to help you with your mechanics. Generally in real fighting, and I like this title back because the dude's head is moving. Generally, the second punch is probably all you're gonna need right there. It's hard to just keep, man, it looks cool in the Ip Man movies, but people are moving. And if you hit the target's swinging around. So maybe 2 punches is good. If you get 3, I'd be surprised. But so don't worry so much about how many shots you're in there. I mean, the point is that you stay compact and you're able to punch from whatever position you're in. It's the other big structural advantage is that you're able to punch wherever you go. You can transport this punch around, right? So the punch can spray fire anywhere around this entire box. And that's awesome because the best defense is a good offense. The best offense is a counterattack. And the best counterattack is a straight punch to the face because it just keeps coming in and keeping people busy. So the other big thing, don't drop the hand. Don't get overextended and drop the hand. Everything should stay to the point where you're able to repeat and there's another punch coming. Now this hand structurally can grab. So in other words, if I punch and I miss, I can still grab him and start punching with the other hand. In other words, this doesn't have to be like a passive hand. If you ever think about, you know, the ocean, the waves are one thing. It's the riptide, you know, the undercurrent that's causing a problem as well. And that's kind of what this retreating hand could be doing. The retreating hand, don't just neglect it. Just don't punch and kind of drop that hand like, oh, it's done now. Make sure you're very cognizant of the retreating hand having an action. It could be grabbing and pulling, okay? A couple of good habits to get into is to change the way the retreating hand is going to go. You know, you could be pulling, it could be guarding, it could be grabbing. And so the better you get at that, you don't just think it's just constantly punching, the more versatile the punch becomes. The idea with all of this stuff in Wing Chun is that you have versatility with simplicity. Follow that, boys and girls. You have versatility with simplicity. And that's a hard one to get. It confuses a lot of people. It definitely confuses people in Jeet Kune Do. They're trying to figure out, you know, the simplicity of the straight lead with the diversity of tactics. So when you're doing this punch, remember, you're learning so much. The Wing Chun system is amazing in its ability to convey a bunch of detail to you that you didn't even know you were learning. My job as an instructor is to kind of come by and help you unlock that and understand what your body is really learning to do. You don't get too hyper literal. You don't become too boxed in with it. And you think, well, okay, the only thing I can do here is this. As I was trying to show you, is you can do a lot more with it. But you can't be making fundamental mistakes. Next thing, you get more power in this than people think. If you stay relaxed right up to impact, you get a bit of a jolt. The shoulder and the hip, everything's loose, and you're punching with the stance. You're punching with your EG Kim Young Ma or your Silam Tao stance. You're developing power in the stance as you're going because you're learning where your hips are. A lot of people mistake what a good punch is. Especially novices, they really like to swing. And I'm not saying there's no momentum on that. That's not going to have any power. But it's somewhat referred to, like we like to say here, it's like paying your mortgage on your credit card. You can do it, but it has a problem. You know, it's like telling your wife she does look kind of chubby in those jeans. You can do it, but it has a downside to it. Can you get more power in this? A lot of people end up just and it don't have any power in it. The Wing Chun punch should be a powerful punch because you should be aiming through the target and you should put some hip and shoulder in it. So if you watch, the punch locks out right at impact and it relaxes. So you have a convulsive grabbing motion. Now, some people talk about snapping the wrist. I don't recommend that. Snapping the wrist is a good way to catch the timing wrong and end up hurting your hand. And you kind of get a limp wrist on the, if you hit bags with it, it's not going to be good. You're going to miss a few times and your wrist is going to start getting a little wobbly and you're going to have a wrist problem. So what you're really doing is it right at impact, the wrist, you grip and there's a solid punch. You don't want to be, I mean, you're not going to hurt anybody doing that. You've got to hit this guy. I mean, if he's trying to hurt you and you tap him and slap him, he's rocking your world around the corner or top. As Dempsey again said, anytime you extend your hand for a tap, anything, you're running the risk of getting nailed with a counter punch. So he's going to be a lot less alert to counter if he's defending against bombs rather than taps and slaps. So bomb them. I love that line, bomb them. This punch should have some meat on it. This punch should be powerful. You should be able to be mobile, and you should be tracking him with your basic weapons, okay? And don't worry so much about the speed of your chain punch. I mean, that's wonderful. But like I said, people are moving. So hitting them 3, 4, 5 times is somewhat of a movie deal, or you're Robin Williams and Popeye and you're hitting the guy there. Another really old movie reference. Man, I'm dating myself in this video bad. But seriously, if you can hit this guy solid, especially you can hold him and hit him. You can't do that in boxing. You know, you can grab his hair and hit him and maybe pull his hair out and then go like your Bruce Lee and Chuck Norris. That's cool. But make sure you're relaxed and that right at the pop, the punch pops and then you relax. That takes time to get good at because it's natural to be stiff, to telegraph, and to be stiff all the way through the motion, or to take all the meat off of it and just end up slapping. But the Wing Chun punch is not that. Structurally, it's relaxed, and then it's pow. And if his face is here and you're hitting here, you're not hitting there, you're hitting over here. You're hitting through the target, okay? So you can't have a knockout puncher who's a Wing Chun guy. And that sort of irritates me. All of my students, they know, they hear me rant about this forever, is that if you throw a punch and it doesn't have any meat on it, there better be a good reason for it. I mean, if it doesn't have any seam on it, okay? That's the big key to this, is that make sure, like if I hand you a hot dog bun, there's no hot dog in it, you're looking at me like, well, dude, what'd you hand me a hot dog bun for? There's supposed to be a hot dog in it. Right, throw a punch with some meat in it. Don't throw a punch and just bing, 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 bing. You know, here's your hot dog, here's your ketchup, there you go. So put it together, it becomes a really, really versatile weapon. And I know I'm all over the place in this video, but hopefully it's been entertaining and educational. My video is free, don't complain. But but seriously, the big thing, three knuckle landing. Can you use the top two knuckles? Yeah, but look at what it does to my wrists. Can I fire a vertical fist? Yes, but look at what it does to my knuckles. My knuckles start coming in first. Can I get more power by swinging around? Yeah, maybe get more power. But there's a downside to that. Like I said, it's like paying everything on your credit card. Eventually, you're gonna have to pay that sucker off. You can just marry rich, but that's another. But seriously, making sure you relax and you hit through the target. So you align the shoulder and hip, and you get that in the second form of Chum Q, where you're reaching the target. I don't know, I'm gonna go into a bit more detail I need to here, but think about when you're looking in Chum Q and you're moving, you don't reach for the target. If you can't hit it, kick it. If you can't hit it with your fist, kick it. If you can't step with it, okay? And if you still can't reach it, you're not in a fight, man. You can leave. This guy's moving around, bouncing around. Hey. Just close the door. That's not a real fight. If you're in that kind of a stalking match, that's not a real self-defense scenario as we know it. So, make sure again, take your time to learn to punch and don't make the mistake of thinking you've got to be throwing 20 punches at a time. Get quality, not quantity. Don't go for 10,000 punches. I'd rather have my guys stand here, use their stance, and make sure when they punch, everything's loose. Because you get so much power putting the relaxation and then the explosion, that convulsive grab, not the wrist snapping. Again, I think that's an easy way to hurt your wrist. So don't do that. So 1, 2, okay? I like this bag because it's moving. And it helps you with some timing. And keep economical movement. Stay economical, and it's easier for you to make adjustments. All right? That's it for today. But definitely click the like and subscribe button. Give us a big thumbs up. The dude that keeps giving me the one thumbs down dude, the guy that hates puppies and everything, God bless you. Bless your heart, as they say in the South. Things will get better soon. Anyway, hope you guys have a good one. Hope you enjoyed the video. Catch you next time.